Joe Biden, current president of the United States, well, looks like he had classified documents as well. Looks as if Republicans are really upset about the fact that Joe Biden was in receipt of classified documents, at least according to the current narrative. Let's dig into it. Aides to President Joe Biden have discovered at least one additional batch of classified information. So there was one batch, now there's two. In a location separate from the Washington office he used after leaving the Obama administration, according to a person familiar with the matter. Two sources said that less than a dozen documents with classified information or classified markings were found at the office. The archives referred the matter to the Department of Justice. Okay, this is what you call a normative protocol. If they are discovered, you do not engage in cover-up. You do not try to eliminate the chain of custody. You do not try to engage in criminal activity to protect one man, even if that man happens to be the current president of the United States. Now let's provide context to the number of documents. According to the reports we have now, they are not obviously as numerous as Donald Trump and the allegations against him. So if you believe that Joe Biden should face the music because 12 documents, maybe they find more later. But if you believe he should face the music for having in his possession at one time classified information outside of the protocol of the United States government and their processes for declassification, you must have already concluded that Donald Trump needs to go to prison for the crimes that he committed as it relates to having classified documents. There's more nuance and more detail that must be explored. So since November, since the month of November, after the discovery of documents with classified markings from his former office, Biden aides have been searching for any additional classified information that might be in other locations he used, said a source who spoke on the condition of anonymity to provide details about the ongoing inquiry. The White House did not reply to a request for comment, not immediately. The Department of Justice had no comment. So now the White House has commented, and basically they're saying, well, it's ongoing. There was no cover up. I'm paraphrasing, but they provided no meat on the bone. Okay? There's more. The initial discovery of classified information in an office used by Biden after his vice presidency was first reported on Monday by CBS News. The classification level number and precise location of the additional documents was not made immediately clear. It was also not immediately clear when the additional documents were discovered and if the search for any other classified materials Biden may have from the administration, former being Obama administration, is complete. Biden aides have been sifting through the documents at locations, stored at locations beyond his former Washington office to determine if there are any other classified documents that may need to be turned over to the National Archives and reviewed by the Justice Department, the person close to the source and the information said. Biden's lawyers followed proper protocol by first notifying the archives with the first batch of classified documents. They did not notify Biden first, they notified the archives. The person said, but because the Justice Department got involved and the president's lawyers were then in touch with them, in the second instance, the lawyers simply went directly to the Department of Justice. But the key questions remain unanswered about the stash of classified material, including who brought them to Biden's private homes and what specifically was contained in them. Now, I want to remind everyone, there are multiple federal statutes that deal with the handling of classified information. Typically, it requires mens rea or intent for a criminal act. You can be negligent and grossly negligent to the degree that you can be charged with a crime. But you can also be forgiven of it if it was done as an accident. An accident that's not gross or grossly negligent, that is possible. It is also possible, based on the reporting that we've heard so far, that Biden staff members may have inadvertently done so. Well, you find that out through investigation. The bottom line is the investigation should not stop just because Biden is president of the United States. I would lack intellectual integrity if I submitted to you that somehow this should not be an ongoing investigation because it happened to Biden. Not at all. It should. There should be an investigation. It should be thorough. It should be accurate. And it should be transparent. And damn it, if Biden did something illegal, he should face the music. Period. There's no ambiguity with that with me. If Donald Trump did something illegal, he should face the music too. Now, let me remind you of the Trump situation. The New York Times called and cited a person briefed on the matter as saying the material is from what the government calls special access programs. This is what Trump is alleged of stealing, which relate to extremely sensitive operations. According to the Washington Post, an unnamed source said the material dealt with nuclear programs. On Friday morning, Trump denied he has such classified material. That's what happened with Trump. Trump said, no, I never even had classified material. Then all of a sudden, we see truckloads of it. He said, no, I didn't have classified material. But then the archive said, give us back the classified material. He did eventually comply, but it was partial. They came back and said, can you give us the classified material? Then they mandated, give us the classified material. Trump still decided not to comply with the mandate from the federal government. These are very different actions. There's a narrative that Donald Trump himself took the classified documents, not a staff member by accident. Once again, a different contextualization. Beyond that, a special access program is a really different type of specialized program. It is so classified that typically it is outside of the normative hierarchy of classification. You do have to possess top secret clearance, but beyond top secret clearance, these programs typically exist in silos. Now, I can argue why these particular programs may be harmful to America. I can also argue why all of this secrecy is not even needed, at least to the degree that the CIA and others would like you to believe that it's needed. But the reality is Donald Trump is not accused of simply taking 12 documents or 15 documents from the White House. He's accused of taking maybe thousands of classified documents, and they connect to programs so highly classified that even the CIA director or the DNI director cannot gain access to these programs without proper prerequisite approval. That's your difference. All right, this is the thoughts here.
Yeah, I mean, the difference is there was a raid on Mar-a-Lago. This Department of Justice decided to do that. I mean, anyone who thinks that this Department of Justice is overly partisan is not living in our reality, which is that Merrick Garland goes above and beyond to make sure that he does not appear at all like he might be a little partisan. I mean, for them to raid Mar-a-Lago, you know it had to deal with something big. And from what we know of Donald Trump, if he could do it, he probably did it. If he could try and barter and sell nuclear codes, he probably did it, or nuclear information. Not sure if the actual codes were there. You know, that might have been a little too much. But look, this is red meat for the right. We all know what's going to happen. We know what they're saying already. We know what Donald Trump is saying. He's drawing a false equivalence between these two things when there are none. The difference to me is that piece that you talked about, Dr. Richey, is that it is the intent. In the case of Donald Trump, they willingly took documents and then intended to conceal them from the DOJ and the National Archives. They were like, no, you can have these. Okay, fine, you'll have a little bit more. Okay, fine, you'll have to raid me for the rest. Biden's team finds these old documents, pre him being in the White House documents, right? Old documents, and they're like, they tell on themselves, which is generally what you should do. You should say, hey, guess what? I found these documents. I didn't know they were there. I'm telling on myself to the National Archives, to the DOJ. Then there's an investigation. The same thing happens, I'm sorry to draw this parallel, with any kind of Me Too or sexual assault allegations. When they involve Democrats, they talk about it, they speak up about it. You got Matt Schlapp of CPAC currently not even under investigation, alleged to have groped a staffer. What do Republicans do? They don't admit it. They just don't know, because it's okay when they do it. It's okay when they do it. They are utter hypocrites and they relish in being hypocrites. But as you pointed out, we have higher standards.
Yeah, everything is going as it should go when there's an actual hierarchy and not people who believe they're in a cult.